Hi children, today we will do exercise 5.2, question number 3. Now, move to the third question. The adjoining figure P parallel to Q and find the unknown angles. What is given there in the question? P is parallel to Q. If two lines are parallel, which are the lines P and Q? These all are same figure, okay? Listen, this is line P and this is line Q. Okay, line P and Q are parallel. What is given there in the question? Line P and Q are parallel. So, if two lines are parallel and this is the transversal, is it? This is the transversal. This is the transversal. Okay, if two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, we already studied three properties. The corresponding angles are equal, each pair of corresponding angles are equal, alternate interior angles are equal, and interior angles on the same side of the transversal is 180 degree, or you can say it's supplementary, and vertically opposite angles are equal. Okay, now we have to find this unknown angles. Unknown angles means this A, F, D, B, C, that angles we have to find. Okay, now how will we find it? And we know that P and Q are parallel. And look at this figure. This is 125. This angle is 125. And angle E. What about angle E? We know that angle 125 and angle E are adjacent angles and they form a linear pair also. Linear pair means what? Sum of the two angles 180 degree. Why we are saying that angle sum is 180 degree? Because that they are in the straight line. Okay, they are standing in a straight line and we know that sum of the angles at one point on a straight line is 180 degree. And so E plus angle E plus 125 degree is equal to 180 degree. What is the reason? Because linear pair means adjacent and supplementary. Okay, so from this equation we can find angle E. Angle E means by using our transposing method, what you will get? 180 minus 125. 180 minus 125, what is the answer? 180 minus 125. 10, 5, 7, 5, 0. So, what is the answer? 55 degree. Okay, so we got angle E as 55 degree. Okay, now angle E 55 degree. Okay, now you can see that angle E and angle F are vertically opposite angles, is it? Angle E and angle F are vertically opposite angle. And this is one line, this is another line. Okay, so we already learned if two lines intersect at one point, we can say that the vertically opposite angles are equal. Okay, vertically opposite angles are equal. So what you can write here, angle E is equal to angle F. So what is the value of angle F? 55 degree. I hope it's clear, children. Angle E and F are vertically opposite angle. So, what you can write? Angle F is equal to 55 degree. What is the reason? Vertically opposite angles. Okay. Vertically opposite angles are equal. So, we got the measure of angle F. What is the measure of angle F? 55 degree. Okay, so we got angle F as 55 degree. Angle E, we already got it as 55 degree. Now, so we got angle E and F. Now, we will find out the next unknown angles. Next unknown angles means A, B, C, D. And look at the figure, children. You can see that angle, just go through the properties of our parallel lines. If two lines are parallel and if a transversal cut two lines, we already studied corresponding angles are equal. Corresponding angles are equal. We know that angle E and angle A are corresponding angles, is it? Angle E and angle A are corresponding angles. So, what you can write here? Angle A is equal to angle E. What is the reason? Because they are corresponding angles and corresponding angles are equal. So what you can write, that is equal to 55 degrees. So what is the measure of angle A? What is the measure of angle A? 55 degree. What is the reason? Corresponding angles. Okay. Corresponding angles. Now, so we got angle A as 55 degree. Angle A as 55 degree. What is the reason? Because corresponding angles are equal. Now, like the same way, you can see one more corresponding angles here. 125 and angle D are corresponding angles, is it? 125 and angle D are corresponding angles. And we know that corresponding angles are equal. So, what is the measure of angle D? Angle D is equal to 125 degree. What is the reason? Corresponding angles. Angle D is equal to 125 degrees. So, what is the reason? Corresponding angles. I hope it's clear. Is it clear, children? Angle D is equal to 125 degree. What is the reason? Because this angle and this angle are corresponding angles. And if two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, corresponding each pair of corresponding angles are equal. That's why we are saying A is equal to E and this angle is equal to this angle. So, we got angle A is equal to 55 degree and angle D is equal to 125 degree. Okay, children? And we know that angle D and angle B are vertically opposite angle, is it? This is one line and this is one line. If two lines intersect at a point, this intersecting point, the vertically opposite angles are equal. So, if this is 125 degree, we can say angle B is also 125 degree. What is the reason? Vertically opposite angles are equal. So, what you can write here? Angle B is equal to 125 degree. What is the reason? Vertically opposite angles. Okay. Vertically opposite angles. Like the same way you can find angle C also. Angle C also. Angle A and angle C are vertically opposite angles. Is it? Angle. This is one line. This is one line. Okay. We know that angle A and angle C are vertically opposite angles. If two lines intersect at a point, the angles opposite to that vertex are vertically opposite angles and they are equal also. So, what you can say, angle A and angle C are vertically opposite angles. So, what will be the measure of angle C? We know that angle A is what? Angle A is 55 degree. Angle A is 55 degree. So, we can write angle C is also 55 degree. Angle C is equal to 55 degree. What is the reason? Vertically opposite angles. I hope this answer is clear. By using the properties of the parallel lines, we are finding the answer for this unknown angles. What is the first property we use here? First property. We know that, listen children, this and this form a linear pair means they are adjacent angles and supplementary. So, what you can write here, this is equal to 180 degree. Okay, this is equal to 180 degree. And by transposing method, what you will get? Angle E is equal to 180 minus 125. What is the answer? 55 degree. Okay, so we got angle E as 55 degree. And we know that E and F are vertically opposite angles. E and F are vertically opposite angles, is it? So, this is the common vertex. This is the vertex and angle E and F are vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles are equal. So, what you can write here? Angle F is equal to 55 degree. What is the reason? Vertically opposite angles are equal. And we already studied angle E and angle A are corresponding angles. Sit. Angle E and angle A are corresponding angles. Okay. So, what you can write? Angle A is equal to 55 degree. What is the reason? Corresponding angles are equal. Corresponding angles are equal. And like the same way, angle E and A are equal. What is the reason? Corresponding angles Like the same way you can write angle D and 125 degree are corresponding angles. So we got angle D as 125 degree. And how will we find angle B and C? They are, this is a common vertex. B and D are vertically opposite angles. So they are equal. So B is equal to 125 degree. A and C are vertically opposite angles. So C is equal to 55 degree. I hope this answer is clear. That's all for today. Thank you, children.